Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm going to start this video out with the boring part, which is where I'm going to go over all of the most important supplies that I use to do dip powder manicures. So, what you first need is dip powder liquids. So there is the base, which is what's used to glue the powder on to your nail. The activator, which is what's used to basically cure the powder as if curing acrylic, and you need the top. You can also use gel top coat with your dip powder, which I prefer. So I'm only showing you what I use. People use different things, different brands, whatever works best for you. This is just what I use, what I've learned to love, and that's what I'm going to show you. So when it comes to dip base liquids, you guys have seen this before. This is Triple Vitamins base coat. This is the best liquid that I can find. There's a lot of good liquids. There's a lot of really good liquids. This is the top, but it is expensive. And I know it like sells on Amazon, but I don't know if those sellers are legit from the manufacturer. So if you buy it straight from Triple Vitamins website, I mean, for me, it ships, it's like $9 shipping, and the bottle's already like, what, $11, $12? I don't know how much. So it's expensive. But I think if you're a beginner, this liquid is so easy to use and work with, and it dries so slow. So if you're a beginner in dip powder, I almost recommend, even though it's expensive, starting off with Triple Vitamins base coat. It's just, until you get used to learning how to do it, then you can move on to more cheaper priced base coats, and I'll show you which ones are still really good. But I can't help you guys. This one is my absolute favorite. I love it. So other base liquids that I've learned to use and really love also, and are a little bit cheaper than Triple Vitamins, and you guys, you're going to hear my toddler in the background because YouTube's not a full-time job, so baby's still here. So Dipalicious's base coat. This is also doubled as a top coat. I haven't tried it as a top coat yet, so I like I said, I prefer gel top coat. This is also a really good base liquid, and it is a little bit cheaper than Triple Vitamin. Not to mention that Dipalicious has, you guys, sorry you guys, he was pushing his power wheel around. So anyway, Dipalicious liquid is still really good. It's a really thin liquid, so you might need to add a couple extra layers to thicken up your dip powder and make sure that it's strong and sturdy. But I like the thin, especially for beginners. It gives you time to slowly build your nail up and build your apex up without it just glopping on, and then now you got a lot to file, you know what I mean? Another good base liquid is Manny Mogul's base coat. My only issue with Manny Mogul's base coat, which if I can get this bottle open because I got oil on my hands. Okay, I'm gonna show you something. My only issue with Manny Mogul's base, which I took mine out, but when you open her bottle, inside was this clear thing, but it didn't have a wiper, so it gets really goopy really fast, so the liquid kind of goes everywhere because it doesn't have a brush wiper in there, which I'll show you what I mean in some of these other bottles. So here's the Triple Vitamin bottle. Do you see inside there those like little clear pieces? That wipes my brush off when I pull it out, so I don't get too much liquid, and so my liquid doesn't go all over the neck of the bottle, which will glue your bottle shut. Let me show you Dipalicious. Same thing there. It's really hard to tell, but those little things like poking inwards. So that's my only complaint about Manny Mogul's liquids. So other than that, this is a really good liquid. The way it performs is awesome. I've never had an issue with it. Only issue is a little bit of the bottle put togetherness, however you would say that. Okay, so now moving on to activator. I have bottles, I have this bottle and a full bottle of Triple Vitamins activator, so I use it, I love it. Almost any dip company is gonna have an activator. Manny Mogul sells a spray activator, which is really cool if you're working with chunky glitter and you don't want to clear cap it, because clear can add another layer. So then you can just put a layer of base down and then spray it with activator, because if you brush on activator and then go to put, if you put down a layer of base and then brush activator on top of it, you're going to mess your brush up. So that's where the spray activator comes really in handy. So now for gel top coats. Manny Moguls, I really do like her No Cleanse top coat. It's really shiny. It seems to last. It's just a teeny bit goopy. So other than that, it's a really good top coat. You just got to work with it. One of my favorite top coats that I used for a long time is the Triple Vitamin Strong as Steel. And all of these are a No Cleanse top coat, so you don't have to wipe it with alcohol. Once it's cured, it's done. But again, Triple Vitamin is a little expensive. This is a bomb top coat, but I found something that works just as good and is way cheaper, which is the Sparkling Co. No Wipe Gel Top Coat. This is what I'm wearing right now. It is super shiny. In person, it looks like your colors are encased in glass. I haven't had it dull out on me, and I haven't had it chip either, and I only use one layer. I don't, like, do two layers of gel, which you totally can do. But for gel top coats, money-wise, these two I would recommend. So after you're done with your manicure, you want to put cuticle oil on like it's nobody's business. I highly recommend Candy Skincare, which I'll try to leave links in description for everything. Candy Skincare has such bomb liquids and so many scents. This is Tropi Way, which is basically Hawaiian Tropic. Manny Moguls also has really good cuticle oil. Just get yourself some bomb cuticle oil. Trust me, you're going to want it. Here's something else I highly recommend. Get a clear powder. You can use acrylic just like dip powder. The only difference is that acrylic is a little bit rougher to file. But let me just tell you. The Mia Secret Clear Acrylic is super clear. It doesn't bubble. It doesn't get foggy. And it is cheap. Like, I got this 4-ounce tub, which this tub is huge, for like $13 and change on Amazon. And of course, you don't have to go 4 ounce. You can go 1/2 ounce, 1 ounce, 2 ounce, whatever. But I use a lot of clear. $13 for 4 ounces of clear is cheap. I like to put a layer of clear down on my fingers first. So I'll literally go from cuticle area down first, the first thing I do, and put clear. Then I'll go on with my color, and I always clear cap everything. I just love to clear cap. Because this is harder to file than dip powder clear, when I clear cap, when I put a layer of clear over my glitter colors or any color, I don't have to worry so much about filing straight through the clear and filing off my pretty powders, right? I'd have to do a crap ton of filing to be able to eat through this. When it comes to removal, though, is like I use an e-file, and I feel like the wear time also helps it file off easier. It's just, trust me, if you're going to get a clear powder, I highly recommend Mia Secret. So for hand files, this is obviously worn. Sally's Beauty Supply sells these. This is the brand Beauty Secret. I think this is their direct brand. This is a 100 by 180 grit file. These files are really good for the price, and you can get them in store. You know, obviously you can order these cheaper ones. They work really good, but they're only good for like maybe one or two uses, and then they're pretty much trash. A buffer block. I only really use a buffer block to go around here to make sure I don't have any sharp edges or corners, make sure nothing's scratchy. But you can get a bunch of these polar blocks really cheap on eBay, on Wish, on Amazon. Brushes. Get yourself a fluffy brush, a kabuki brush. This is an old e.l.f. complexion brush, and this is literally kabuki brush from the Dollar Tree. To brush off your powder. What I highly recommend doing as well, which this you can also get at the Dollar Tree, or you can get online, packs of them cheap. This is a hard bristled brush. I will dust off my powder with this first, making sure that everything is stuck, it's not still wet, brushing it off, and then I'll go on with here and I will hard brush. And I will make sure I get every excess powder off. This saves my dip liquid brushes from gooping. It also, with the clear, it helps make sure that my clear is crystal clear. There's no excess powder there at all. I don't want any fogginess and I don't want bubbles. Highly recommend getting that. When I'm applying chunky glitters. I like to use sample baggies, which you can get at like Michael's. I just had a small one. Here's a big one. There's smaller ones. Where to go? Which you'll see here in this video coming up. So that way you can pat down the glitter really flat without it sticking to your finger and without lifting a bunch of glitter off, which, like I said, you'll see in my application here in a minute. If you want your dip powder to last a really long time, you can get something like Sparkle & Co.'s PH Prep, basically a dehydrator. Also, you can use alcohol. Alcohol I highly recommend, which, you know, alcohol is cheap. Isopropyl alcohol. That'll help dehydrate the nail, cleanse the nail. I use alcohol to wipe my nails before I top coat it to make sure that there's nothing in there. If you want something to wear, like, let's say you want to wear a manicure for just a week or a couple days, try getting like a peel base. Sparkle & Co. sells really good peel bases. Here's something a little extra, which you can find, like, if you go to the dip powder communities on Facebook, you'll find people make these with their 3D printer. These are really cool. Like, when your bottle starts getting low on liquid, it holds it at an angle, so that way you can just continue. You don't have to, like, tip your bottle and do all that fancy stuff. That's just an extra implement. That's not a necessity. And starting out, you're obviously going to want things like a cuticle pusher to help you get through here. Push your cuticles back and scrape a little bit of that extra cuticle off. So now let's get into the actual video where I'm showing you how I apply my dip powder. Okay, you guys, the colors that I'm going to be using is Double Dipped Elfin Magic. Somebody sent this to me, so it's a little sample of it. And I'm also going to be using Manny Mogul's Above the Clouds. This is also a sample. And I like to put a coffee filter underneath here just to catch the colors, so that way I don't have to worry about, you know, I could just continue doing my nails. I don't have to worry about spilling. The coffee filter will catch everything. So I've already applied my one layer of clear. So now, starting off with color, I go first halfway down the nail and dip, which I'm going to show you on each finger, and I'm going to leave it in real time so that way you can see. The first layer, I only go halfway. The reason why we're doing this is to help build an apex. Shorter nails, you don't need a very big apex. Longer nails, you're going to want to build a little bit of a taller apex. An apex is just going to help keep strength in your nail where they won't snap, they won't break, they won't crack. So as you can see, starting off halfway the nail down to the free edge, which is the very tip of the nail. It also helps to dip. If you're going to dip your finger straight into a jar, dip it at a 45 degree angle. That just helps the powder go on smoother. You can also pour powder on. Pouring powder on helps keep the layers super thin. So now that we've done halfway, now I'm going to do about a third of the way. So right under the cuticle area. I'm not going all the way up just yet. I went halfway the first layer, a third of the way the second layer. And sometimes, because right here I'm using Dipalicious base coat, which is a really thin liquid, so sometimes I even add a fourth layer of color. The amount of layers of colors that you use really depends on how you want your nails to look. How is your apex? How long are they? So do you need it thicker? How big are your nail beds? So do you need a little bit thicker there? So now that you can see why I use a coffee filter, though, because I'm pouring that powder on and I don't want to have to sit here and focus on making sure I'm not making a mess. I just want to get in there and go. So coffee filter is awesome. Paper plate, cupcake liner, anything like that. Anything that you can taco and make a taco shape to be able to pour back into your jar. So now I'm going to do the other fingers in real time, going a third of the way, not all the way to the cuticle, just kind of close to the cuticle area. And I'm leaving out the middle and ring finger right now because that's where I'm going to put Above the Clouds. So now I'm getting out above the clouds. This isn't the most chunky glitter, but it is a little bit of a chunky glitter. So I'm going to show you. I'm going to treat this the same way I would big giant chunk glitter dip powders, okay? What I like to do with chunky glitters is I like to pour the powder completely out. That way I can get it to lay flat. And again, since this is my first layer, I'm starting out halfway down the nail. And then I like to lay my finger flat, lay my nail flat into the chunky glitter. And then I'll show you that I use the sample baggie to help pat the glitter down even more flat on my nail. This just helps keep those glitters flat because the chunkier glitters, they're gonna stick up everywhere and you wanna get it as flat down as possible. So you see here, I start off very gently patting those glitters down, and then as the liquid is drying, I start to add a little bit more pressure and I just try and get them as completely flat as possible, which I'm going to keep this all in real time so that way you can see. And I'm gonna do the same thing to the ring finger here. So now back to Elfin Magic. This is now my third layer of color. So now I'm going to go all the way up to the cuticle area. If you flood your cuticle area, you can use a toothpick or your cuticle pusher to kind of just run it along and sort of scrape off while the powder is still wet to help keep that area clean. Now that I'm on the third layer, I'm going right up to the cuticle area, and I'm going to do the same thing for the other nails that I have Elfin Magic on. Now I'm speeding this process up. All I'm doing is now, since this is my second layer of chunky glitter, I am putting the liquid up to the cuticle area. I don't do it three times because the chunky glitter is already going to make it a really thick thing. And keep in mind that in between doing the powder, when I'm brushing off with not only a soft brush, but the hard bristle brush to make sure that there's no excess powder on there. So that way nothing's getting into my liquid brush. This is where I felt like I didn't have a thick enough layer. So I'm just doing a fourth layer from the cuticle area down to the free edge. Again, this is probably just because the Dipalicious base liquid is really thin. I'm not complaining. I like that it's really thin. It lets me build up my nail how I want it. It doesn't give me too much at once where now I have to struggle to file it down thinner. So that's what I'm just doing here. I felt like I needed an extra layer. So I added an extra layer. There's nothing wrong with that. So here's another tip when working with chunky glitters. Sometimes it doesn't get in certain areas all the way, and you'll have like a thinner spot or a almost a bald spot. So I'm just adding a little bit of liquid in the area where it's really sheer. And I'm taking a small eyeshadow brush and I'm tapping that in that area this way instead of dipping it, because if you dip that one little area, you're gonna have a really thick random spot on your nail. This keeps it thin but gives me coverage where I had a bald spot. And I'm just like turning my finger around, looking all around, make sure none of my natural nail is peeking through. And wherever that I feel like it is peeking through, because maybe I didn't dip it there in time or it didn't get enough liquid in that area or whatever it may be, I'm just adding liquid right where I need it and sprinkling on, so that way it doesn't make a really thick lump in that one area. That just makes working with chunky glitters even easier to deal with. After I'm done showing this part, I go straight to the finished product. So let me tell you that I did add a layer of clear over this, and then I activated, and then I filed and shaped. And if you're using gel top coat, you don't have to put a second layer of alcohol, or I mean a second layer of activator down. Sorry, you guys, you're gonna hear my toddler. Yeah, when you're using gel top coat, you don't need that second layer of activator. You just go right in with your top coat and cure that in your lamp. So here is the finished look. All this video was is just showing you how I do DIY nails at home. You can buy everything without having to have a tech license. And that's it. I'm going to try to remember to put links to everything that I talked about in the description, except for things that you can find simply in store, like the hand file or the cuticle pusher you can find at Sally's Beauty Supply or Walmart or wherever. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you later.